Page, I'm glad to see you. Is Sir John Falstaff here?
Oh, now, master, you'll complain of me to the king.
Knight, you're beating my men. Kill my deer and broke up my law.
Ah, but that kiss your keeper's daughter.
This shall be answered, sir.
Oh, very well. I will answer it straight. I've done all this. There, the matter is answered.
The council shall hear of this, sir. Merry knight, I have matters in my mind against you and your holy country. Rascal pistol.
My purse is nearly dry. I must go to cash. No, you thought of this time.
I can go right.
Ah, then, my honest man, I shall tell you what I am about. Briefly, my duty is to make love to Ford's wife. Briefly. Love is the race, son. I always win. I spy entertainment to her. Take two of boys. They are. I've written her here a letter. And here another.
White.
To Page's wife, who even now gave me good odds, too. Examine my parts of
those really
judicious
like
accolades.
Oh, then the son of Dunhill Sound.
Oh, she did so poor, so my treasure of ingredients. They shall be my east and the west of these. I shall trade to them both. Go now, deliver this letter to Mistress Ford and this letter to Mistress Page. We shall thrive. We shall thrive.
Davids has got this little piece of straw in his hand. Put his hand up into his mouth.
Ask me no reason.
My wife is not young.
I heard that.
Take your pills. You are so high
and low. Rich and poor. Young and old. One with another. Believe it, Ford.
I will seek out Falstaff!
If your worship tomorrow, shall I vouchsafe a word or two? Pray, come no nearer this way.
What says she to me?
Mary, she has received your letter, and she gives you to notify that she has come here in the Grumbler's house between 10 and 11.
10 and 11.
Aye, so it is. Her husband, Master Ford, will be from the house.
10 and 11. Woman commendable. Though, I must ask, has Ford's wife and Page's wife acquainted each other with how they love me? Long enough.
Oh, sweet Saint John!
What made me love thee? Let that persuade me. There's something extraordinary.
Do not betray me, sir. I fear that you love Mistress Page.
I might as well say, I love to walk by the counter gate, which is as hateful to me as the leap of a lion gate. Shall not see me. Evelyn scourge me behind the arches.
May you do so. She's a very tattling woman. Let's record it. Let's put a post in it.
I live to be carried in a basket, like a barrel of butcher's offal, and thrown in the Thames. Well, if I be served such another trick, I'll have my brains taken out and buttered and given to the dog as a New Year's gift.
Thank
you.
It was quite warm.
Oh, I brewed it myself.
You made me do that?
Oh, yeah. It's an IPA, well.
I hope it's not too bitter. A lot of hops.
Oh, yeah. Miss Quickly to see you, sir. Let me pour some sack into the Thames water, then. Sorry. Come in, woman!
I come to your worship from Mistress Hall.
Mistress Hall. I've had enough of the fall. I was thrown into the fall. My belly's full of fall.
Alas, the day grew hot. That was not her fault. She does take on service for men. They used to be very wretched.
So did I mine, to build upon a foolish woman's pride.
Well, sir, she laments for it. This morning her husband goes a burden. She desires me to come to the Lord. You must send her the clock. She will make you amends. I warned
you. Very well, I will visit her. Tell her so.
Bless you, sir.
Oh, and you as well, Master Brooke. You come to know what has passed between me and Florida's wife.
I'll spend you, sir.
Very ill-favoredly, Master Brooke.
Oh, how now, sir? Did she change her determination?
Oh, no, but her husband, who had admitted to you a alarm of jealousy, comes to me in the instant of our encounter. After we had embraced, kissed, protested, and, as it were, spoke the prologue of our comedy, to search for his wife's love.
Wait, sir, while you were there, sir?
While I was there. Pistol, what's taking so long?
I did his search for you, sir, but could not find you.
Oh, you shall hear. As luck would have it, in comes one Mistress Page, who gives intelligence of Ford's approach. And by her invention and Ford's wife's distraction, they conveyed me into a buck basket.
A buck basket?
By the Lord, a buck basket. Brand new foul shirts and smocks, foul stockings, greasy napkins. That there was the greatest compound of villainous smell that ever offended nostrils. Thus rammed in the basket, a couple of Ford's knaves were called forth to carry me in the name of foul clothes to the laundress. They met their jealous knave, their master, at the door, who asked them once or twice what was in the basket. I quaked with fear, as the lunatic knave would have searched him, but fate, ordaining he should be a cuckold, held his hand. Off he went for a search, and away I went for dirty laundry.
Well, sir,
Sweet Sir John, my hair falls in balls on us.
Oh,
that. What shall I do? Get out, creep up the chimney. I'll go out then.
But let our plot go forth. Let our wives yet once again to make us public school. Opposing me is so not better. But we shall take it and disgrace it.
Well, there is no better way than that they spoke of.
What? To say 10 words that we leave in the pocket at night?
Fine. He'll never come. You say he's been thrown in the river.
Yes.
He's just been grievously beaten as an old woman. And he thinks he shall not come.
How let us two divide to bring him thither?
Ah, there goes an old
tonight or never. Be you in the park, near Herne's Oak round midnight, and you shall see wonders.
Oh, sir, were you not with her yesterday, as you had all pointed?
So I went to her, as you see, like a man.
Oh.
But I came from her like an awful
oh.
That jealous day for being grievously in the shape of a woman.
Oh.
Poor in the shape of a man, Master Brook. I fear not the lion with
oh.
Even sleeve. Follow me, Master Brook, and I shall tell you strange tales of this knave Ford, upon whom tonight I shall be revenged, and whose wife I will deliver into your hand.
Ooh, tell me more, sir. Tell me more.
Where is this quickly and a troop of fairies?
See how I'll come to the pick on my hands,
though. We will betray him finally. The hour draws on. Lillian!
And the fattest I think in the forest. Send me a cool rut time, Job, or else who can blame me to piss my tallow? Ah, who goes? My dough.
Like her, the hunter.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Pottery!
Well, he's free to speak to them, shall die! Heavens defend me from that Welsh fairy, unless she transformed me to a piece of cheese.
Easy chase, let the flames back descend, but it starts, it is the flesh of the corrupted heart. Oh, it's so bad. I'll see that mortal rod and deadly chin to your time.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have been
the Earl of Leicester's Lair!
Stay there. I promise it's going to be worth it.